If a user for the first time comes onto our app, then he first has to register to get into the app. Once he registers, he will be onto the front page which we had previously shown in the implementation part. So for medical support, he can go to the medical support tab, and clicking on this icon will take him to this page where he can write his query. This question, if it is red, if it's in the red card, that means it has to be yet to be answered, and if it's in the green card, it is answered. So this will be answered by only by doctors. So if you post a news, then it will tell the validity of the news, that if the news is true or false. So in this way, this will work. And similarly, this live news, it will give the live news feed at every instant regarding corona. So here you can either support community in the form of money, then it will directly take you to one of the UPIs which you select so they can pay. And if you select food now, then you have to give your details and submit so that a volunteer will come to your home and will take your food.
The first learning which we had during this hackathon was that we can manage things remotely. We had been into hackathons like in previous years and previous months, but we had never been working remotely. We had been working together in a group and we had been solving problems.
We learned to work from remote areas, like that was the major learning from us.
We divided the work into front end and back end, so some of us took care of the back end like Firebase and everything. Some of us took part in front end one.
We got an experience to see more documentation and understand how the documentation has been framed.
We learned how to use GitHub. We learned how to use other platforms where we can share code. So using that, how we can interact with each other and build things.
I specifically worked on UI, user interface, not into the backend like Firebase. It gave me about the essential part of the user interfaces to develop in Android.
Most of the tech stack which we used in the prototype or the solution which we built was completely new. So we had to learn it to solve it.
Taking Firebase as an example, we didn't know anything about that. We went into the documentation of the Firebase website, we searched it, and we knew what we are going to use with Firebase. So we searched specifically for that task and like how it can be done. Or we even called our seniors whom we know who are familiar with this Firebase, and in that way we managed.
Freedom to choose what we want to solve. So Yantra was completely flexible at the problem statement. They were fine with whatever we built as a prototype or built as a solution that can impact the real world situation at these COVID pandemic times. We are actually thinking to share this with governments through social media platforms like Twitter and all. So if they really like it and if any changes are suggested, we are thinking of making the changes and deploying it onto app stores.
I think this would give scope for everyone to think out of the box. Like they'll be at their home and they'll be having this freedom to think and also surf about the different ideas.
I feel like everybody should participate in Yantra Hackathon. Reason being, you will learn things in a very effective way because the deadlines at Yantra are very strict. So because of that time constraint, you will learn things in an effective way which you will be using and implementing it in real time to build your prototype or product.
They feel very happy since we are using this quarantine time in very much useful protective activity. We are doing protective activities. And they also thought we as a student also can contribute to our society.
They were encouraging to participate in more of this. We were indirectly or directly impacting the human society.